Halloween is coming and you're going to hear a lot of trick-or-treat sounding on your door. And if you love this celebration, wow, you're gonna have a blast. But in this video, I'm going to talk about the psychology behind Halloween and how much is this actually revealing about human behavior and human psychology. So let's see this video. Hello and welcome to Good Mind Channel. My name is Eugene Popa, and on this channel we talk about psychology, human mind, human behavior and emotions. So make sure to subscribe and also click the notification bell to get notified every time we post a new video. So back in the 1970s in Seattle, there was a study about how kids behave when they have full access to, let's say, goods. How they did this? On Halloween day, kids would ring a door, and the one who ran the study would open the door and would just tell the kids, I don't have much time, I have work to do, I'm gonna go back into my room, but here's a jar of candies, and actually next to it there was also a jar of money. So say, here's a jar of candies, just go ahead and pick one candy only per person, and then he just left the room. Now, the response he got from kids was, there was a huge gap, let's put it that way. The kids were actually deviating from this request anywhere between 7% to 80%. So basically 80% of kids would actually not follow the guidance, but actually take more than just one candy. So here's how they done this experiment. Kid enters the room and an experiment, actually done three experiments. Experiment number one, the kid was asked the name and their address, where they lived in the neighborhood. Now, when kids gave their name and address, only 7.5% of kids took more than one candy. Only 7.5 took more than one candy. So how they run this experiment? Well, they actually ran three experiments. They wanted to see if kids come alone or in a group, if they identify themselves, and also there was a third experiment, I'm gonna tell you about it in a second. So, if kids came alone and also gave their name and address, only 7.5 of them took more candy. All the others, they didn't, they only took one candy. But 7.5 took more. This is the lowest limit. The highest limit was 57.5% took more candy, so almost 60% took more candy if they came in a group and also did not identify themselves. So these were like the range. Came alone and identified themselves, came in a group and did not identify themselves. And this is actually something very known, which is called deindividuation or anonymity. So basically, if you don't know who I am, if you don't know anything about me, then I will be anonymous to you. So therefore, that's kind of like a license to misbehave. And we see this a lot with riots. We see this a lot with people in big groups who are doing stuff that they would never do if they're by themselves. So when people are in huge groups, and they can, you know, they go and commit a lot of acts of vandalism, or they do other things that they cannot even conceive afterwards that they have been doing those things. But because when they are by themselves, they are themselves. There is also a third aspect. When kids come to your door, they're not just kids, they are costumed, and that adds to deindividuation, adds to the anonymity aspect. So that's a huge, huge, kind of like a mask that we are hiding behind. So when we are in a group, we hide within the group, so actually you cannot identify me or any other person because it's a huge group, it's a mass. If you don't know my name, if you don't know my address, if you don't know my age, if you don't see me because I'm in a costume, if I'm in a huge group, then this anonymity factor goes through the roof as far as 80%. So the third experiment they've done, which reduces the individuation, was very, very cool. Basically, they put a mirror behind the bowl, behind the jar of candies. So now kids, even if they came in a group or by themselves, whether they gave their name or an address or they didn't, the very fact that there was a mirror behind the jar and they would see themselves in the mirror would reduce drastically the number of candies they would take. Because right now they would be faced with themselves, they would see themselves, and they would be kind of identifying themselves in that mirror. Even though they wore a costume, they would still be able to say, this is me. So This, like I said, tells us a lot about this concept of deindividuation or anonymity, and actually tells us, like I said, a lot, because when we are not being held responsible, when we are in a group of people, when we can do whatever we want to do, and there's gonna be nobody able to come and say it was him or her who did it, then that's kind of like revealing so much about yourself. So my question to you right now is, have you done this before? Have you acted differently in a group, rather than compared to when you're by yourself? How about when you wear a costume? Do you behave differently when you wear a costume versus when you're in a normal attire? I would love to hear your comments. I would like to hear about your responses. Write them in the comment below, in the comment section below, in the comment box. I'll see you in the next video. I'm gonna put another video soon about why do we love scary movies? Why do we love to be frightened and scared? And click on this box here, because the video is going to come up right here and you're going to see that video in the next moment. So thank you so much for watching. Make sure to subscribe, click on the video, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.